بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، نبينا وإمامنا وحبيبنا وقرة عيننا محمد بن عبد الله، وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين. أما بعد، I try to say what I want to say it in English, but my language is not good, so take it easy. What I want to say about this time, we talk about Shia, and they have some question about Sahaba when they are with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they have three questions, three problems they think. The first one, they say the Sahaba and the Al have the fights for dunya, and they don't like each other. And the second one, they say about Sahaba, after the Prophet Muhammad died, they became like before he came, Muhajirin and Ansar, don't like each other. And the third one, they say about Sahaba, when they are with Prophet Muhammad, they don't want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They want money, they want dunya. What do you mean?
Dunya? Dunya ma'ruf.
Dunya ma'ruf. They want dunya. That's the three things what we talk about it, inshallah ta'ala. The first one, they say there's a fighting between Sahaba and Al, and that's liars. They lie. Why we say that? Because we talk about Prophet Muhammad and we say he loved his Sahaba and they love him. And when we say that, we have to make dalil. What the dalil?
Proof.
Proof. For that. So we see Prophet Muhammad, he married Aisha, she's the daughter of Abu Bakr, and he married Hafsa, and she's the daughter of Umar, and his daughter Fatima married Ali ibn Abi Talib, and his daughter Ruqayya and Umm Kulthum married Uthman. He married Ruqayya before, and when she died, he married Umm Kulthum. That means the Prophet Muhammad liked them and loved them, and they like him and love him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ali ibn Abi Talib, after that, he gave Umar his daughter, Umm Kulthum, the daughter of Ali, and Fatima. Umar married her. That mean Ali like Umar and love him. And Umar love Ali and like him. All of that marriage between Sahaba and Al, it means something. They like each other. And that's what Shia don't want it. They say no, they are fighting. They
that they dislike.
Dislike?
Yeah.
They dislike each other. And that's not good, not right. We see Ali Nabi Talib radiallahu anhu, his son Umar, and the other son Abu Bakr, and the third son Uthman. But they say Ali have three sons, all of them their name Umar. The big Umar, the wasat Umar, medium Umar, and the small Umar. Three Umar Ali have. And Al-Hassan have Umar. And Al-Hussein have Umar. And Ali ibn Hussein, his son Umar. What that mean? And Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه, when Abu Bakr died, he married his wife, Asma bint Umays. So Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr, the son of Abu Bakr, Muhammad, when Abu Bakr died, Muhammad, his age 2 years just. Rabbah, tarbiyah.
Raised and trained them, raised them.
Ali, when he married Asma, he take care for Muhammad. All his life with Ali ibn Abi Talib. And he is the son of Abu Bakr. They don't dislike each other. No. That's what we say about Ashab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And something we have to say it about Sahaba and the Al. If they dislike each other, they don't live like that. Their life, it's different. That's what they say, the Shia say. The Shia say they fighting, they dislike, and we see the other things between them. And look, Ashab Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they fighting with A'da, with in the Futuhat, Jihad, they are in Jihad, all of them together, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Hassan, Hussein, Abdullah bin Umar, Abdullah bin Abbas, together. What that mean? And when they say they don't like each other, that's liar. And the other things, after Prophet Muhammad died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he died, they say they go back Muhajirin and Ansar. And they leave Islam. Let us look for that. Who fight the Murtaddin? Abu Bakr. And who is with him? Umar and Uthman and Ali. Ali has son, his name Muhammad. Ask anyone, who is his mother? The mother of Muhammad, the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib. His name Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyyah. We don't say Muhammad ibn Ali. We say Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyyah, the son of the Hanafiyyah. Hanafiyyah, his mother. From where? From Jihad with Abi Bakr. She is before with Musaylima. Harb, fighting with Murtaddin, with Musaylima. And when Abu Bakr fighting them, and they انتصروا.
They conquered them. They beat them.
They beat them and take this woman, and Ali married her. That means Ali accept what Abu Bakr do. And look, Al-Hussein ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Khattab, Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr al-Siddiq. They married sisters. The daughter of Kisra. Hussein take one, and Abdullah ibn Umar married her sister, and Muhammad ibn Bakr married the third sister for them. And after they have Ali ibn Hussein from this woman, and Salim ibn Abdullah ibn Umar from the other woman, and Al-Qasim ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr from the third woman. What they say about Ashab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not right because they are together always. Always together. And they don't back Muhajirin and Ansar. No. They still like they're with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
مرتدوا. When he said that they don't back the Muhajirin Ansar, means that they didn't apostate. They didn't leave Islam, the Muhajirin and the Ansar.
Yes. And when they say they just go with Muhammad for dunya and for the king and for money or anything other, we say, look, what Abu Bakr have before and what Abu Bakr have after? What he have? Before, he is a rich man in Mecca. And when he go with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he leave everything. And still with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he die, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr was the Khalifa. After, what he take from dunya? Nothing. Nothing. So Umar say, when he came after Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, أتعبت من جاء بعدك. What that mean? أتعبت من جاء بعدك.
You made it difficult for the one, Abu Bakr, you made it difficult for the one who comes after you, meaning he was a hard act to follow.
So Umar came, and what he do? And Abu Bakr before that, Abu Bakr, when he, before he died, did he give his son something? No. He have Abdullah, he have Abdurrahman, he have Muhammad, he don't give them anything. He leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Umar come after Abu Bakr, and he don't take anything from this dunya, but he give it. And Uthman, you know about Jaysh al-Usra. He give the Prophet Muhammad many things, and all his money. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, he say, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَانُ مَا يعني مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَانُ مَا فَعْلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ.
Uthman will not be harmed by anything that he does after preparing this army of difficulty.
And Prophet Muhammad, very funny, after Uthman, do that. And what he take from dunya? Nothing. Nothing. He leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ali same. We don't say anything about Ali. They think when we like Ashab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we don't like Ali. That's not right. We like them all. Ashab Muhammad and the Al. We like all. We love them. Because they are the Qudwa for us.
They're an example.
So, when we talk about Ashab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we talk about Al Bayt Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we don't say they are in the side and they are the other side. No, it is one side. And all of them in this side. They want to say no. The Ashab in the side and the Al in the other side. We don't accept that. And we don't say that. And they say in the Ashab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they have many mistakes in their life. We don't accept that. We say they have mistakes. All the people. Just the prophets, they don't have mistakes. But all the people. Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Fatima, Aisha, Hassan, Hussein, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Zubair, Az-Zubair, all, and you, and me, all the people, they have mistake. Who, from you, I ask you now, who don't have mistake? No one. All the people have mistake. But we talk about the mistakes. What that mistake? It's big or small? It's many or one or two. We talk about that. What that mistake? We think Ashab Rasulullah SAW have mistakes. And Ali have. All of them. Not different. But we say Abu Bakr is the best. And the Umar, and Uthman, and Ali, and the other. That's what we say about Ashab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say about this mistake about Ashab Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they talk about it. They say when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam want to die, he say something, I want paper. I would like paper in that time. I want something to write something. He don't write in his hand because he is ummi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he want someone to write that. He want to write something. But he is very sick, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his sick is different. Abdullah bin Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, when he go to visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he is sick, he say, I see you, it's very hard for you. He say, yes. When I'm sick, I'm like two people, not one people. Like two people have the tired. He say, it's that because you take two ajr? He say, yes, for that. And when Umar look to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he is sick, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, "Give me something to write it," Umar say, "No, leave Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He need to rest." They say, why Umar say that? Umar don't want Rasulullah to write something. What that thing? Rasulullah, he want to write, Ali is after me. He is the Khalifa, after me. How they know that Rasulullah want to say that, or he want to write that? They just think that. And when Umar say that, some people in the room, they say, no, bring what Rasulullah SAW need. Umar say, no, Rasulullah SAW tired, very tired. We have everything, alhamdulillah. Let him rest. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he see them talking about that, someone say, bring it, someone say, don't bring it. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, please go out, all go out. I don't want noisy in that time. And they take it and say, Umar, don't let Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam write what he want to write. And when we look for this subject or this mas'ala,
this issue.
طيب. When we look for that, we say, look, is Ali ibn Abi Talib was there or not? He's there, Ibn Abi Talib. He's there. So, why he don't write? In Musnad Ahmed, in the book, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say it to Ali. Talk with Ali. He say, Ali, bring this like jild. What the mean jild?
Skin.
Skin to write something for it. Because they don't have paper in that time. He say, bring it. Ali say, look, you are very tired. Say it. Say what you want. I can understand it. Say it. And Rasulullah say it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He say, take care about salat. Take care about zakat. Take care about abid,
slaves.
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 Okay. And he say it, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Ali hear it. That's enough. And we want to ask question. Is that things what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam want to write? It's something he must do it or not? If it's something he must do it and he don't do it, what that mean? That mean Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam don't say everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to say it. He don't say it. So that mean Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam don't do everything Allah wanted. And that's kufr. That's kufr. We talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we say no, it's not something he must do it, but he like to do it. It's something different here. So we don't accept what they say about Umar radiallahu anhu. And that's things. It's happened in Thursday. In Thursday. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad, he died in Monday. So he have how many days after? How 3 days? Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. 4 days, he don't say it. If it's something he must say it, he can say it after. And he go out in Monday morning, in Fajr, Salat Fajr. He go out from his house and look for Sahaba when they are go to pray and see them, and he smile, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That mean he accept what they do. And he go back to home, and after he die, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, when they say Umar do something bad, that's not good. Umar do what he must to do it. And let we say, okay, Umar do something bad. Does that mean he is kafir? No. Okay, mistake. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in some day, he go out from his home and knocked the door for Ali and Fatima in the night. And he knocked the door. And Ali say, who? He say, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad, he say, are you sleeping? Ali say, yes, we are sleeping. And Prophet Muhammad say, why you don't go to pray? Qiyam al-layl. Why you don't pray? Ali say, our nafs.
Our souls.
Our soul with Allah hand. When he want up, he want us to wake up, we wake up. He don't want, we don't wake up. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he knocked his fakhdh, his leg, and he say, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا. He don't accept that from Ali. Why you say that? When I told you, go to pray, you say, okay, inshallah, and do it. Don't say it's with Allah. Okay, we say Ali رضي الله عنه have this mistake, but we don't يعني talk bad about him. No, we love him, and we say he is have mistake. Okay, Umar have mistake, Ali have mistake. What happened? What that mean? It's not mean anything. And when we want to talk about this, the mistakes, what Ali do, what Abu Bakr do, what Uthman do, what Umar do, we have many. I don't mean many, I mean we have something like that. But we don't like to talk about that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. These people go. Don't talk about them. Talk about yourself. Look about yourself, what you need, what you have to do. Don't talk about the other. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to do, subhanahu wa ta'ala. هاشي.
اوكي هاشي.
اوكي ها اكيد شور زين. انا اي ثينك اي توك اند يو سليبينج. اوكي and the other thing what they say about ashab ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they talk about after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, they fighting for khilafah in the same day. Okay, I ask you again, in which day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died? In Monday sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he died in Monday, something strange for Sahaba radiallahu anhum. All of them think they will die before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They don't think Rasulullah, maybe he will die. He is sick, okay, but he will be okay after. But he die? No, they don't accept that. I don't think about that. Okay, he died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he die, there are three kinds from people. Some people don't accept that, and they say he don't die, he will not die. They don't think he is God, he is Allah. They don't think that, but they think still, not now, he don't die. Just maybe he's go like Musa go 40 days and go back, but not die. And the other people say he's died, but they still sit in their house. They don't go out like Ali, like Uthman, like Zubair, like Talha. They sit in their house and put their hand like that and thinking. And they are hazin.
They were sad.
Oh. Okay. And Abu Bakr, he's out Medina when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died. And they told him, because he is in the Fajr, in Monday, Salat Fajr, Abu Bakr was there. And he is the Imam for Salat. After Salat, he go to visit Rasulullah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he see him good. And he ask him, do you need something from me? How I can go to my wife in Awali, outside Medina, his wife, Habiba. He have four wife, Abu Bakr. Okay. He say, I have to go to my wife. Do you accept that? He say, okay, you can go. And he go to him. And after 4 hours or 3 hours, Prophet Muhammad died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they told Abu Bakr, he's died. He came back and go in his house, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam house, and look for him, and he is died. He kiss Prophet Muhammad here and cover him and go out. When he go out, he say, Umar say, anyone say Rasulullah die, I kill him. Rasulullah don't die. And the other people, they shut their mouth, don't talk anything. And the other sit in their house. As I say before, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, go to the minbar, and he say, look, ما يعبد من كان يعبد محمدا.
Everyone was worshiping Muhammad.
Okay, Muhammad, he is die. And who fair worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah don't die, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he say, وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا وسيجزي الله الشاكرين.
And Muhammad is nothing but a messenger. And there are many messengers who went before him. if he were to die or if he were to be killed, will you people turn back on your heels? And whoever turns back on his heel, he doesn't hurt Allah any bit. And this is how Allah rewards those people who have a shukr.
They accept that from Abu Bakr. And Umar go down and he say, yes, I accept that. And Anas and Ibn Abbas, they say, we think that the first time we hear this ayah, we forget. After that, Ali and Abbas and Zubair and Usama, they go to wash Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before
before they buried him.
Okay. And Abu Bakr, Umar, Abu Ubaidah, Talha, all the Sahaba, they sit out, wait. In this time, many people from Ansar, Sa'd bin Ubadah, Bashir bin Sa'id, and the other, they sit in Saqifah Bani Sa'idah. What's that, Saqifah? Duwaniya, Majlis?
At the assembly. It was an assembly, sit-in place.
Okay. They are there and they say, what we do now after Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died? What we do? Some people say, okay, from Muhajirin, someone, and someone from us. They are the Hakim. What do you mean Hakim?
The leader.
Okay. The leader, someone from them and someone from us. And some people say, no, just from us. And the man from Ansar, he heard that, he don't like it. He go to Umar. He told him, look, Ansar, they sit there and they talk about this way, these things. So Abu Bakr, Umar, don't talk about that. The Ansar talk about that. And when they hear that, this man told Abu Bakr and Umar, and they go to them. Abu Bakr and Umar and Abu Ubaidah go to them, and they told them, what do you say? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad say, the leader from Quraysh, not from you. Why you say that? The leader from Quraysh must be. And they say, okay. After Abu Bakr say, okay, take it, Umar or Abu Ubaidah. Is the leader? Umar say, no, you are the leader. That's what happened. They say, no, they don't stay after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam die in the same day. They look for the leader. No, they don't look for the leader. That's the one. And the second one, if they look for the leader, what's the problem? All the people now don't accept when the king or the leader die. He must have other one to take care. But now, you know, some leaders, some kings, when he died, they don't say he died. Just after they see who is the other, all of them, but they don't look for that. That's what happened from Ansar, not from Muhajir, not from Abu Bakr and Umar. And Ali accept that when they say that. Ali accepted when they told him what happened. And after Abu Bakr came the leader, Khalifa, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and after Abu Bakr, Umar, and after Umar, when they kill him, Abu Lulul al-Majusi, they leave it for six people, Uthman, and Ali, and Talha, and Zubair, and Abdurrahman bin Auf, and Sa'ad, Nabi Waqqas. And he say, you can look for anyone from you. And they, like Uthman, that's it. But that not mean they are look for dunya or look for money or something like that. No. But some people say what? Say when they sit in with Ansar and Bani Sa'ida, Saqifa, Bani Sa'ida, they say, Sa'd bin Ubadah say, I will kill you, I don't like to pray with you, I don't go to Hajj with you, and all of that lie. The problem, many people talk about tariq and they are liar. Like Lut ibn Yahya, Abu Mukhnaf, and like Nasr ibn Muzahim, and Saif ibn Umar al-Tamimi, and al-Waqidi, and Muhammad ibn Sa'ib al-Kalbi. They what say the tariq, the history, and they are liars. They are liars. We must know that. And we must take care about that. Anyone say anything about Ashab Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we must take care he is liar or not. There are many liars. And you have to take care about that. Okay, that's it. Yani, if you want to say something to me.
Yeah. In the end, inshallah.
Okay. The other one, in Shura. Shura, when Umar tried to kill him, or he killed him, Abu Lul al-Majusi, he leave the leader for 6 men, I told you. And they liar to Umar, he say, when they accept, five men accept, and one don't accept, kill him. When 4 accept and 2 don't accept, kill them. When 3 accept and 3 don't accept, and look who's with him, Abdurrahman bin Auf, kill the other. And when 3 days they don't know who's the leader, kill them all. That's liar. How Umar say that? Just kill. Ah, Umar, don't say that. That mean we have many liars, many things. They liar about Ashab Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have to take care what we read. And Allahu a'lam wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad. Jazakallah khair.
We'll utilize this short period of time for 2 or 3 questions and kind of from as'ila. Have any questions you could put them forward? So the brother, he said that he heard that from the mu'taqid of the people that the shayr is that they believe that some people have the ability after dying to come back. Can he elaborate on this? Is this something that they believe? Is this true?
عن الرجعة.
إيه.
إيه هو يسأل هل هناك من يقول بالرجعة؟
نعم. وما قولك فيه؟
We don't accept that. Anyone. He die, he don't go back. Shia, they say that. Yes. The first one he say it, Abdullah bin Saba. Abdullah bin Saba, he is the first man he say about Ali ibn Abi Talib, he will be back. And Qais ibn Zahar, someone his name Qais, he go to some people and he told them, Ali die. She say, look, when you bring his head, we don't accept. We don't accept. Ali don't die. And when he die, he will be back in this life. Why they say the raj'a? They say that because they think Ali, they say, not all people go back. Just علي حسن حسين علي بن الحسين الباقر صادق the 12 imam, they go back, and not 12, 11, because the 12 Mahdi, he is there. They go back, and their enemy, just. And who is their enemy? Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Aisha, Muawiyah, Yazid, that's it. And they say, and they kill them before Yom Qiyamah. That's what they say about Raja'ah. And it's a liar. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, it's not impossible to go back to dunya, anyone when he die.
The Shiite believe in the Quran, the Mushaf of Fatima. We want to know, is there actually in their hand, in their possession, in their homes, a Mushaf called Mushaf Fatima?
No, they don't have it. Because it is a big liar. Okay? They say when Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died, the Mushaf, well, okay, someone give me Mushaf. Can you? Give me three, please. Three.
Fadda.
Tafsira. Okay. Okay. They say the Quran or Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the life, that's the Quran. Okay? And they are third. The one about Ali and Fatima and Hussein and Hassan, that's it. And the second about Abu Bakr and Umar, some bad things. Okay? And the third one about Salat, Siyam, how pray, how fast, how, like that. Okay? And when Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died, Sahaba, they sit together and say, anything about Ali and Fatima and Hassan and Hussein, we don't like it. Leave it. Anything about us, not good, leave it. Okay? And we accept that just. So they say, what we have from Quran is thilth.
Third.
The third, just. And Sahaba leave this. What happened after that? Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه, he have it all. He give it to Hassan. And Hassan give it to Hussein. And Hussein give it to Ali, his son, Ali ibn Hussein. And Ali give it to his son Muhammad. And Muhammad, at Hassan Askari, he's the 11, he give it to his son Mahdi, and he is now with Mahdi. When Mahdi go out, he bring the third. Okay, so they say Mushaf Fatima is true, but he's with Mahdi, not with us. We don't see it, but we believe it. They believe that the Quran like that with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the life. And after he died, Sahaba take this out. Just leave that. And when Mahdi come back, he bring the third. That's Mushaf Fatima. So now we know about the Quran. How many ayah, Quran? 6,200. They say about the Mushaf Fatima, it was 17,000. What does that mean? A third. 17. So when the Shi'i told you, I don't have, just I have in my home this. You say, okay, but you believe that the third, not all. And you're waiting for the all from Mahdi. When he go out, طبعا ما في مهدي, so yeah, ما في قرآن. When he go out, he will bring the others. That's it.
Okay, Ikhwani, we're going to stop here, inshallah, because the time for the end of the lecture has come. So we want to thank the Sheikh Uthman Khamis for delivering the lecture in a language that we understand. May Allah Ta'ala put his juhud and his muhawala and his mizan of hasanat. And also may he bless all of you for your husn istima'. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم.